Ready.
So as soon as the gun went, the crowds went crazy, right? And I usually listen to the skates behind me to see how close, if they're on or if we're together or not, but I had to actually look back to see if everyone was together or not. So we opened really fast in the first lap. We were 0.3 seconds ahead of the United States in half a lap. And obviously it's the Olympic gold medal final, and I was pretty excited. I was leading the first two laps of the race. Usually you start in about 30.0 seconds. That's a fast start, but a good start. I probably should have relaxed a bit more in the second lap. You can see we're all together, going in a straight line, one behind the other. Exactly matched on crossovers. That's something we practice over and over and over. So there we just did a 25.6 second lap, which is probably way too fast, but we're 0.73 seconds ahead of the US now. I went to the back, now Lucas Mikowski's in the lead. You can see here, I'm just relaxing in the back. It's really easy for me to follow compared to the guys who, whoever's in front has to work a lot harder to break the wind. So now we're doing 26.7 second laps. And we're staying fairly even with the US now. Our gap isn't getting bigger or smaller right now. And right there in the race, you can hear the crowd's cheer change because now our gap went down to 0.4 seconds. Almost half of what it was. And the crowd almost seemed, when we were racing, I could feel like this anxiety in the crowd. Now we're down to 0.28 seconds ahead of the United States. And we're doing 27.6 second laps. Majiru takes the lead, and he knows that we need to speed up, so he cranked this one turn out and almost dropped me and Lucas, but we trained so hard to stay on that we just stayed right in his stride. And we're both hurting, but try to see some relaxation on our faces just to maintain composure and stay right in the stride of Matthew, who's then negative split the lap. He went faster than the lap before, which doesn't usually happen in a race. And our gap's back up to 0.45 seconds. So this is Matt's last lap of pulling, and our gap's increased now to 0.58 seconds, almost 0.6, so we're almost back to the full size gap we had. And as Matt pulls off, I'm trying to really rest on these last laps that he's pulling, because I pulled the first two and now I have to pull the last two laps. And as soon as I took the lead after that exchange, we dropped back down to a 0.3 second gap only over the US. And so they're getting really close now with one lap to go. And 0.26 second gap. And the crowd's kind of going, oh, and they want you to win, so they're cheering hard, but and Majiru's pushing now because he has extra energy and he doesn't have to lead anymore, so he's pushing Lucas, who's then pushing me in the lead. And our gap's increased now. The pushing strategy was something that our coach Marcel kind of developed with us. And it helps the leader maintain extra speed when the guys in behind are dying. So we crossed the line. Matt Giroux looked over to the other side of the rink and saw that we crossed the line before the US. So he was already celebrating before we even finished. I could barely drag my ass across the line because I was so tired. I was just exhausted. So these two are celebrating with the coaches, and I can barely stay on my feet at this point. I actually thought I was gonna puke on national TV with Olympic coverage. It's a pretty fun race to watch. Pretty good memories.